and a rapid manner. Let me move on to the next screen. And we are about at the mid of our presentation, 30 minutes into it. I'll get quickly into demos, but I wanted to leave a small message to this crowd that it's not necessary that you really need Tableau's and the ClickView's and the Spotify's of the world. Those are great tools, but you can almost create data visualization as part of your day-to-day work, your day-to-day reporting. And here are some of the examples where I've been using data visualization using simple tools like even Excel for that matter, to either show a data quality heat map or to show how I'm going to staff a project with resources and what the resource mix is going to be like, or visually represent my project plan so that when I basically stand in front of client, I can just show them what are the activities and how things are going and if there are any hurdles that are happening on the way. Right. If an architect, you could also use data visualization to show your database performances, the bottlenecks, in a very intuitive data visualization, which would be very easy for your teams to understand or your upward bosses to understand what's going on. So with that, let me kind of get into a demo mode and take a look at some of the quick demos that I can bring to the table. One of it is actually a Tableau, and let me switch over to the Tableau screen. And I hope you are able to see the screen. Yeah, you can see the screen. I'll just wait till it settles down. This is essentially, the topic of data is not very great to talk about, but it's talking about accidents in US. This is real data for a specific year in US, and it kind of does a categorization and segmentation around the types of cars involved, the states involved in the accidents and so forth. Right? It's pretty interesting for an insurance company to understand which states are really high on accidents. For example, Texas or California seems to be pretty high, and probably because they are also denser and maybe because of other parameters and reasons. It's also interesting to know which are the top models or cars that have been involved in car accidents, so that either the car makers themselves can learn from it or the insurance companies can understand how to, you know, put up their premium pricing and so forth. Or the city planners can look at the accidents that are plotted on the chart and see what is the density of where the accidents are happening. And you can see very well there are very specific areas where high amount of accidents are happening. Let me take you to a very specific use case that we have built in this data visualization. You can see at the bottom, which is a heat map, which shows the number of accidents that have happened over a period of time. And I'm actually increasing the number of casualties by virtue of that slider. And it will refresh for you. And you can see that, you know, the heat maps are bringing up all the accidents with a high mortality or deaths in that region. I hope it's refreshed for you, because I would want to kind of pull in something more from here. We typically talk about bringing in data from external world and doing a mashup with corporate world and so forth. Here we thought, if I was an insurance company and I was doing a claim processing, and I was doing a claim processing for a specific accident, which happened in on an interstate, there ought to be a news report that came on that incident, right? So it'd be good to kind of pick that data and literally search it on internet if you can get some data. And I'm firing a Google query based on my internal data. Yeah, just give me a minute, and I hope it kind of shows the screen to you. Yeah, there you go. So you have basically all the Google searches of Pennsylvania car bus accident where 45 people were injured, right? I can actually go to that specific site and I can pull in more information like videos and news reports and what was first reported by police and so forth. And in many cases, I can actually derive a lot more insight about that accident than what I would typically have in what was reported to me during claims for that insurance. That's basically kind of, you know, mashing up a lot of your external data with internal data and using data visualization tool like Tableau to take a look at maybe millions of records across 10 years around accidents of data. I'll take a pause and go back to slides before we open up the floor for some questions. Data visualization, as I said, is very powerful tool to kind of, you know, use to make a change. And we've been working as part of our corporate citizenship responsibility on a cause in Mumbai, which is essentially a large number of trees dying in Mumbai city. And if some of you are from Mumbai, you would have seen a lot of news reports or news articles which talks about the number of you know, trees that have died in Mumbai. It's close to 1,000 odd plus. So we decided to do something with it. We thought to use analytics and some bit of mobility technologies to kind of understand what might be happening. So we created a mobile app which could be used to plot the exact latitude, longitude of a tree, and then did a survey of almost 700 plus trees in Mumbai city, going on foot and doing the survey of Mumbai trees. When we did a plotting of all that latitude and longitude on the Google map, and I'm actually just giving you a snapshot, not taking you to a Google map because it will take some time for it to be responsive enough. You could start seeing some trends that came out when we started plotting up all the trees on Google Map for the surveys that we did. The red trees are dead trees, the yellow ones are which are dying, and the green ones are very good. When we plotted it all, we were startled to see that all of those dead trees are majorly around the main streets that that are connecting the suburbs. And interestingly though, in the areas which are quite open, where there are open grounds or lot of free space or less pollution and traffic, we saw that the trees were doing good. And this we are talking about specific species of trees, which is green trees. We checked this on multiple places in Mumbai and we found exactly same time of pattern across various locations. We also see that there are some trees that, you know, are dying which are not on main streets. But they are on basically some of the bypasses to the main street, and you can see that people who are taking basically bypasses to avoid signals or traffic jams take the inside streets, and there is also a huge traffic jam on those small streets where there is a huge casualty of trees. But this started to get very interesting, and we found that you know, we could extend this correlation with intersections where there are a lot of traffic jams and a lot of trees that are dying on the intersections. We saw that the trees are dying extremely with a, on a very high rate of probability where there are a lot of excavations going on because of building work and so forth. And that's obviously because of the water tables that are basically drawn out when there are underground excavations and so forth. We did some heat maps to kind of figure out exactly what's happening, how and where the trees are dying. And we realized that there is a lot of infection and infestation that's happening, which is essentially a mealybug infestation, which is causing the trees to dry out within a couple of months and absolutely die within a couple of months. And we kind of plotted the heat maps and sensed as how these infections are moving from bunch of trees which are in canopy or you know, very close to each other, and how it spreads very easily from one tree to another. And thousands of trees in a line are dying in Mumbai. But it was always difficult to kind of do a survey on foot. For the fact that we are all IT professionals and very less time, we thought it would be interesting to start using satellite images and do some bit of survey using just the satellite images. What we did was we picked up Google images and we did predictive modeling using Revolution R, and we did some image classification, and what you can see is output of that, where we have successfully managed to predict exactly the rain trees that are out there on Goregaon West area, one of the locations in Mumbai, right? So now you can see that there are so many trees specifically covering this zone, which are rain trees. That's a huge green cover, and if all of them die, we would be hardly be left with any of the green cover. We picked up all this data. We kind of took it back to the municipal commissioner. We had some good discussions around the reasons behind the trees dying. We put up some business cases, and now we are working extremely on a close basis with the governance bodies of Mumbai to kind of start saving these trees, put some treatments, put some ways to kind of probably save some trees and so forth. So this is an example where we have kind of used data visualization, mobility, some bit of cloud technologies, GIS technologies, all bringing it together to kind of make a complete difference to way we live around and so forth. So which was want to kind of pause at that with a message that the data visualization is a very powerful way of representing data, learn insights from it, get some actionable insights, and then act on it very quickly. It's very easy to convey a message to either if your business or your IT or your a project manager, doesn't matter. If you can represent the data in a visual way, it's very easy to convey the message, and that would be very easily absorbed, and you can see a good traction on that. With that, I'll pause there and we'll open up the floor for questions. Okay, I'm getting some questions. Give me a minute.